How did the Rishi come to that? Yeah, that's what you're asking. That it's hurt, nothing else. It's hurt. Life hurts all of us. Does it not? Anybody here who has not been hurt? Anybody here who is not carrying wounds? Several times, right? In fact, every day, daily, the ego is a wound that doesn't heal, a festering sore. Is it not? Is it not? Most of us learn to live with the perpetual sense of hurt. Most of us become numb towards our hurt. We say this is life, this has to be accepted. And that's what we also teach to our children. The Rishi is one who says, no, life was not meant to be suffering. He says, no, I do not believe that I was born to face hurt, to bleed, to tremble in fear, to be suspicious, to be struggling in doubt. He says, no, 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 I do not like this. Huh? Like kids who stamp their feet. I do not like this candy. Seen kids like that? Rishi resembles those kids so much. No, 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 no. This is not my nature. This cannot be life. This cannot be life. And then he says, what else is there? Only this is there. I must know, why is it the way it appears to be? Why does it hurt? More importantly, who is it that gets hurt all the time? He asks him out. He dares him to show his face. He says, you are always hurt. You are always feeling bad. Who are you? Show your face. Reveal your identity. And that is koham. That is koham. Without being a little dissociated from aham, you cannot ask koham. He's asking, who is this? And because this is so proximate to I, he's asking koham. Again, 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 he asks. Again, you are hurt. Again mistaken, again defeated, another error, another humiliation, more tears. Why? Why? Who are you? Who am I? That which sparks the process in Rishi, which can be called process only as long as you are the hurt entity. Later on, you surely say, no, it was not a process. But that which sparks the process is available to all of us. It is life itself, life with all its movements, excitements, ups and downs. Something brushes you. Something goes past you. You are attracted to somebody. Somebody appears pleasant. Somebody insults you. There are achievements, there are failures. The Rishi says, what is all this happening? I trust somebody and nobody appears to be worthy of trust. He hurts me, and the one who hurts me is himself hurt. He He's asking, is there something that is fully trustworthy? Is there something which is not a cause of pain? That is spirituality. That is so intimately intermeshed with life. To live life honestly is to be spiritual. Nothing else is spirituality. Rituals, traditions, reading of scriptures. No, not all this. To be sensitive to yourself. To really go into the stuff of your own mind. That is what it means to be spiritual.
The severity of God. We have become, let's say, at one stage you respond, at another stage someone else responds. All of us have our own ignition points when that actual fire should start. Sparks do happen every day, but they don't actually amount to the fire.
Yes.
Now, when this thing came up, probably which we are now discussing. So something has actually taken in there to tell that. To inquire about, say what it is, or to ponder about what actually is supposed to be.
Yes.
So now, how do you explain that in our daily life?
Has something really taken him there? We compared the Rishi to the child. Now, is that example not a revealing one? Has the child been taken somewhere, or have we been taken somewhere? And if the Rishi is similar to the child, then has the Rishi been taken to some special position, or are we the ones who have been taken somewhere? The Rishi has not been taken somewhere. He is where he is in the childlike stage. He is innocent. If he sees X, he says X. If he sees Y, he says Y. Z is Z for him. For us, X is not X. For us, X is Gulab Jamun. Y is not Y. Y is sweetheart. Yes? And what is Z? Z is God. So he has not been taken anywhere. He is standing where he was, at least as a child. We have been taken somewhere. We have covered a lot of distance. We have covered a lot of distance from our center. We have covered a lot of distance from our nature. And because you have covered a lot of distance, let this distance itself become the tool. See how far you have come and see that you do not really like this distance. Let us please drop the notion that the Rishi is special. He is not. We are special. Can we please drop our extraordinary specialities? Somebody likes to put a doctor in front of his name. Somebody is so proud of his knowledge. Special. Somebody looks pretty. Special. Somebody has a fit body. Somebody is so smart. Somebody is entitled because of a relationship. Special. The Rishi is not special. Ordinary, very ordinary. Very, very ordinary, like the child.